بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على أشرف الأنبياء والمرسلين محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين. أما بعد، إن شاء الله I'd like to begin this brief reminder, and we'll try and go through it as quick as possible, with the statement of Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala, where he says, تَبَارَكَ الَّذِي نَزَّلَ الْفُرْقَانَ عَلَى عَبْدِهِ لِيَكُونَ لِلْعَالَمِينَ نَذِيرًا. Blessed is he who has set down the criterion to his servant so that he may be a warner to those that exist. الَّذِي لَهُ مُلْكُ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ وَلَمْ يَتَّخِذْ وَلَدًا وَلَمْ يَكُلْ لَهُ شَرِيكٌ فِي الْمُلْكِ. يعني he who possesses the dominion of the heavens and the earth, and has not taken a son, and there is not for him a partner as it relates to the dominion, وَخَلَقَ كُلَّ شَيْءٍ فَقَدَّرَهُ تَقْدِيرًا. And he created everything and determined it with due measurement. Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala, he states, سَبِّحِ اسْمَ رَبِّكَ الْأَعْلَى الَّذِي خَلَقَ فَسَوَّى وَالَّذِي قَدَّرَ فَهَدَى. He states, glorify the name of your Lord the Most High, who has created everything and then proportioned it, and who has measured and then guided. He has measured and then guided. And Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala says, Inna kulla shay'in khalaqnahu biqadr. Indeed, we created everything with a preordainment or a qadr, a decree. These particular verses show us the greatness and the majestic nature of Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala, and the exaltedness of his action of decreeing and measuring or determining. And as Shaykh Muhammad ibn Salih al-Uthaymeen rahmatullahi ta'ala alayh, he explains al-Qadr huwa taqdeerullah azza wa jalla lil-ashya. That al-Qadr, which we normally translate as decree, it is Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala determining or measuring all things. Determining or measuring all things. Ibn Kathir, rahmatullahi ta'ala alayh, he states, expounding on the statement of Allah, inna kulla shay'in khalaqnahu biqadr, indeed we created everything with or by decree. He states, yastadillu bihadihi al-ayah الكريمة أئمة السنة على إثبات قدر الله السابق لخلقه. He states that the imams, the specialists of the Sunnah, they use this noble verse as a proof for the establishment of Allah's preordainment for the creation. And then he continues, وَهُوَ عِلْمُهُ الْأَشْيَاءَ قَبْلَ قَوْمِهَا. And it is his knowledge and awareness of all things before their existence. وَكِتَابَتُهُ لَهَا قَبْلَ بَرَكِهَا. And he is writing all of these things before they were brought into existence. Faith in this, in the Qadr of Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala, without a doubt, is from that which is obligatory upon the servants. And that is because faith in the decree of Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala is a pillar of an iman. As is seen in Hadith of Jibril, where the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was questioned, أخبرني عن الإيمان. Inform me about al-Iman. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam stated, أن تؤمن بالله وملائكته وكتبه ورسله واليوم الآخر وأن تؤمن بالقدر خيره وشره. That it is to believe in Allah, the angels, the books, the messengers, the last day, and to believe in the Qadr, the decree, the good of it and the bad of it. The good of it and the bad of it. And the Qadr, this measuring or determination of all things, this is done by one who is all wise and one who is most knowledgeable and well acquainted with the affairs of everything. This is important because it gives us a better awareness of who it is to whom which we worship, we direct our acts of worship. As al-qadr, or al-taqdir, it is an action from the actions of Allah. فِعْلٌ مِنْ أَفْعَالِ اللَّهِ Al-qadr wa taqdir. فِعْلٌ مِنْ أَفْعَالِ اللَّهِ It is an action from the actions of Allah. And although in the statement we believe in the Qadr, the good of it and the bad of it, if we understand that this determination or this measurement or this decree or this preordainment is from one that is all wise and all knowledgeable, then we understand that no evil or bad can be attributed to him, to the one that's all wise and all knowledgeable. That only good can be attributed to him. As the actions of Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala are good, there's no attributing bad to them. So what is intended here is that the action of Allah determining or measuring or decreeing, this action in it is good. However, al-naqdur, that which is determined or decreed, therein or contained therein is that which may be considered to be bad or evil. A simple way of understanding this would be understanding this from another action that Allah puts forth. The action of creating. Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala creates. This action of Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala is perfect. No one doubts that. Whatever Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala brings into existence, he creates, it is perfect without a doubt. And in it is good. However, and this is as it relates to the action of creating, however, the created thing, there could be something from amongst the creation, from created things, that has within it evil, that has within it bad. An example of this is al-khamr. Al-khamr, the creation, Allah creating al-khamr, no doubt that this was created with wisdom and with knowledge and thus forth and so on. There was wisdom as to why Allah did this action of creating al-khamr. But the creation of al-khamr, therein is evil, intoxicants, because of what it does to the person that uses or consumes it. So in that same sense, we have al-qadr and al-maqdur. We have the action that Allah does, and then we have the thing that is actually determined or decreed. And it is in that sense where the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and tu'mina bil-qadr khayrihi wa sharrihi. In that sense, the sense that was just mentioned. So in reality, the attachment is not to the action of Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala, but it is to the outcome, or the thing that is decreed or determined, or in the sense of creation, the thing that is created. And sometimes things that are created, or things that are decreed, it may be considered bad to the people from one perspective, but therein is contained good from another perspective. And the people that will recognize and realize this are the people that whom Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala have bestowed insight. As Sheikh Muhammad ibn Salih al-Uthaymeen, he clarifies this point using the statement of Allah Surah Al-Rum, ظَهْرَ الْفَسَادُ فِي الْبَرِّ وَالْبَحْرِ بِمَا كَسَبَتْ أَيْدِ النَّاسِ لِيُذِيقَهُمْ بَعْدَ الَّذِي عَمِلُوا لَعَلَّهُمْ يَرْجِعُونَ. Sheikh Muhammad ibn Salih al-Uthaymeen, or the verse translated to be, corruption has appeared upon land and sea due to that which man has earned with their hands. بِمَا كَسَبَتْ أَيْدِ النَّاسِ, in order for them to taste that which they used to do, so that perhaps they may return. And he made Tawbah. As Shaykh Muhammad ibn Salih al-Uthaymeen states, فَفِي هَذِهِ الْآيَةِ بَيَّنَ اللَّهُ عَزَّ وَجَلْ مَا حَدَثَ مِنَ الْفَسَادِ وَسَبَبِهِ وَالْغَيَّ مِنْ. He states that in this particular verse, Allah makes clear what has occurred from corruption and its causes and the purpose for it. وَالْفَسَادْ شَرٌ. Nobody doubts that. And corruption is evil, and no one doubts that. وَالْسَبَبُهُ عَمَلُ الْإِنسَانِ السَّيِّئِ. But the cause for this corruption, the cause of it, are the actions of people, the evil actions of people. وَالْغَيَّ مِنْهُمْ لِيُذِيقَهُمْ بَعَدَ الَّذِي عَمِلُوا لَعَلَّهُمْ يَرْجِعُونَ. But the purpose for it, for this facade taking place, is that they may taste some of that which they used to do, and that perhaps, and in order for them to return. So the existence of corruption, the Shaykh, he continues, the existence of corruption and its appearance throughout land and sea, fihi hikmah, in it is wisdom. Fahuwa nafsuhu sharrun, but it in itself is evil. However, it is allowed to happen out of great wisdom, and by way of it, its measurement or its decree or its fate in it is good. Why? Because of the purpose for it, the outcome that is reached by way of it. This is something that is under this point that Sheikh Muhammad ibn Salih al-Uthaymeen is making, that from one perspective, something that is decreed or something that takes place may be considered to be evil, but when looked at from another angle, has a tremendous purpose and benefit in it. This is seen in Surah Al-Kahf. When looking at the Issa, or the story of Khidr and Musa, as that which Musa saw from the actions of Khidr was considered to be strange or evil. was considered to be strange or evil. But when revealed as to why these actions took place, then we know that they had tremendous benefit behind them, even though Musa didn't know why when they were taking place. As Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala says, فَانْطَلَقَا حَتَّى إِذَا رَكِبَا فِي السَّفِينَةِ خَرَقَهَا قَالَ أَخْرَقْتَهَا لِتُغْرِقَ أَحْلَهَا لَقَدْ جِتَّ شَيْئًا إِمْرًا قَالَ أَلَمْ أَقُلْ إِنَّكَ لَنْ تَسْتَتِيَ مَعِيَ صَبْرًا. Allah says, so when they went, they left, when they departed, then they rode on a ship. فَانْطَلَقَا حَتَّى إِذَا رَكِبَا فِي السَّفِينَةِ. They rode on the ship and kither damaged the ship. Yeah? Poked a hole and like this, damaged the ship. So Musa said, do you do this in order to drown his people? Indeed, you have come with something that is strange, not evil. And kither responded to him, did I not tell you that you would not be patient with me? When the story continues after a verse, Musa's response, but the story continues, Fam talaqa hatta ida laqiya ghulaman faqatalah. They departed until they met a boy, and he killed the boy. Kithr killed the boy. Musa said to him, Aqatalta nafsan zaqiyatan bighayri nafs? لَقَدْ جِتَ شَيْئًا نُقْرًا. Have you killed an innocent, have you taken an innocent life, yani, without due right? Indeed, you have come with something evil. Anyway, these stories are well known to us. The stories are, should be well known to us. If it's not well known to anyone from amongst us, then we need to read Surah Al-Kahf more. The point is, the things that Kevin did, they were considered strange and evil things on the apparent. But when looking at why they were done, there was a benefit that was not understood. For instance, when Kidda explained to Musa about the ship, أَمَّا السَّفِينَةُ فَكَانَتْ لِمَسَاكِينَ يَعْمَلُونَ فِي الْبَحْرِ فَأَرَدْتُ أَنْ أَعِيبَهَا وكان وراءهم ملك يأخذ كل سفينة غصبا. As for the ship, then it belonged to some, to the working class poor who worked in the sea. I wanted to damage it, as there was a king that would seize the boats by force. So he would see that this boat was damaged and wouldn't have any desire for it. The point is, there was wisdom behind the things that he did. And he later on he says, وَمَا فَعَلْتُهُ عَنْ أَمْرِي. I did not do these things out of my own accord. I didn't do these things out of my own accord, showing that this is what Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala wanted. In this story is a lesson for those that hope to understand the decree of Allah, the good and the bad of it. That in reality, no bad is attributed to Allah, because Allah may allow things to take place in His creation. But the things that He allows to happen, there's wisdom behind it, even if we don't comprehend it. It may be evil from the apparent perspective that we see, but from another perspective, these things are allowed to happen by one who is all wise. Who is all wise and in control of everything. For this reason, it is incumbent for us to actualize belief in foreign affairs in order for us to have proper faith in the decree of Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala. To have proper faith in the decree of Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala. And at first, and we try to go through this as quickly as possible, the first thing that a believer should have belief in is al-khulq. And that being that Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala has created everything. That Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala has created everything that we see in His existence. And that there is nothing that is found in His existence except that it is from Allah's creation. As Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala states, Allahu khaliqu kulli shay'in wa huwa ala kulli shay'in waqir. Allah is the creator of everything. And He is the waqir over everything. And Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala, He says, ذَلِكُمْ اللَّهُ رَبُّكُمْ خَالِقُ كُلِّ شَيْءٍ لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا هُوَ فَأَنَّا تُكْفَكُمْ. That is your Lord Allah, the creator of everything. There is no deity worthy of worship and truth except Him. So how is it that you are turned away? How is it that you are turned away? These expressions that Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala is mentioning are in a general sense with no exception. With no exception. Meaning everything that you find, Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala created it. Everything that Allah Tabaraka that you find in this dunya, it is created by Allah. This is important. Why? Because even evil, which is an aspect of the creation, is something that Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala created. As Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala, He says, قُلْ أَعُوذُ بِرَبِّ الْفَلَقِ مِنْ شَرِّ مَا خَلَقَ. Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala, He's given the command. Say, indeed I seek refuge with the Lord of the dawn from the evil of what He has created. From the evil of what He has created. Here, there is a secret refuge with the Creator from the evil that is found within His creation. This is an acknowledgement from Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala that He has created within the creation things that are considered to be evil. Things that are considered to be evil. And Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala, He says, وَمِن كُلِّ شَيْءٍ خَلَقْنَا زَوْجَيْنِ لَعَلَّكُمْ تَذَكَّرُونَ. And from everything we created, pairs. So that perhaps you may remember. وَمِن كُلِّ شَيْءٍ خَلَقْنَا زَوْجَيْنِ. Imam al-Shawkani, rahmatullahi ta'ala alayhi, He states concerning this verse, Zawjain, from everything we created pairs, yani sinfain wa nawain, two classes or two types, min dhakar wa untha, from males and females. Right. We're in pairs. Well, barri wa bahr, land and sea, wa shams wa qamar, the sun and the moon, وَغُلْغُلْ وَمُرْ sweetness and bitterness. وَالسَّمَاءُ وَأَرْضُ the sky and earth. وَاللَّيْلُ وَالنَّهَارُ the night and the day. وَالنُّورُ وَالظُّلْمَةُ and light and darkness. وَالْجِنُّ وَالْإِنسُ and men and jinn. وَالْخَيْرُ وَالشَّرُّ and good and evil. And good and evil. He, Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala, has created things in pairs. He created good and He created its opposite, evil. And then He explains why. لَعَلَّكُمْ تَذَكَّرُونَ as إمام الشيخ محمد بن صالح الأثيمين explains لعل when using the Quran for تعليل he's showing the purpose why لعلكم تذكرون so that perhaps or in order for you to remember إمام الشوكاني continues أي خلقنا ذلك هكذا لتتذكروا فتعرفون أنه خالق كل شيء. He states, meaning, we created that so that you can remember. Thus you know or are aware that indeed He is the creator of everything. وَيَسْتَدِلُّ بِذَلِكَ عَلَى تَوْحِيدِهِ وَالصِّدْقِ وَعَدِهِ وَوَعِيدِهِ And thus this, that you may use this as a proof for his singular nature, for him being singular and singled out, and the truthfulness in his promises and his threats. Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala created everything in pairs and in opposites, but Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala is the only one that is singular. There is no pair for him. This is showing us the grandeur or the greatness of the Lord to whom which we worship. Why is this important? Why is this important? That no one actualizes belief in Al-Qadr unless they believe that Allah created everything. But why? Because we have a group from amongst the 72 destroyed sects, as the Prophet ﷺ referred to them, known as Al-Qadariya. And to my knowledge, this is the only sect that the Prophet ﷺ mentioned by name. To my knowledge. As we have an authentic narration that is in the Sunan of Abu Dawood, of Abi Dawood, the Sunan of Abu Dawood, and there is authentic narration, and it is upon the authority of Abdullah ibn Umar, where the Prophet ﷺ stated, Al-Qadariya Majus Hadith al-Ummah. That the Qadariya, they are the Majus of this nation. Why did the Prophet ﷺ state this? As the ulama, past and present, explain that they imitated or they resembled the Majus in their fundamental belief. As the Majus, they believe that all good was due to the actions of light, was an action of light, and evil was an action of darkness, from the actions of darkness. This is what they believed. The Qadariya resemble them in that, as they state that good is from the actions of Allah and evil is from other than Allah. As if Allah did not create evil. As if Allah did not create evil. So the Qadariya, they are a group from amongst the deviant groups of the past that had a misunderstanding as it relates to the decree of Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala. And so this is one of the things that must be believed in, that Allah created evil, everything, good and evil, in pairs and out of wisdom. That's the first. The second is belief in Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala's knowledge. Belief in Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala's knowledge. Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala knows everything. That Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala knows everything. And the proofs as it relates to this particular subject are in abundance. The name Al-Alim, which is mentioned in the Quran 157 times, is sufficient as a proof to show that Allah is all-knowing. Why? we stated and we frequently state, that all names of Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala point to complete and perfect attributes that are free from flaw and defect. And this name is no different. Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala, His knowledge is perfect. It was not preceded by ignorance, nor will it be succeeded by forgetfulness. That Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala is the one that knows all things, that which is public and that which is in private, that which is apparent and that which is concealed. Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala knows the past in detail, that which is present, which is occurring in present times, and that which will occur in the future. There is nothing that is hidden from Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala. Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala, He knows what is and what will be, and He knows what would be if He allowed something to be. This is what is intended by the name Al-Alim. So based off this name alone, this is a proof that points to the fact that Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala has knowledge of everything, is aware of everything. But likewise, we have statements of Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala in His noble book. And this is not to prolong the issue, but Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala says, Allahu alladhi khalaqa sab'a samawati wa min al-ardi mithlahunna yatanazzalu al-amru baynahunna لِتَعْلَمُوا أَنَّ اللَّهَ عَلَى كُلِّ شَيْءٍ قَدِيرٌ وَأَنَّ اللَّهَ قَدْ أَحَاطَ بِكُلِّ شَيْءٍ عِلْمًا. Allah states, Allah is He who created the seven heavens and the earth, the like thereof. And his command or decision descends between the two, between the heavens and the earth. In order for you all to know that Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala has control or is capable of anything, and that Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala undoubtedly surrounds everything by way of His knowledge. He knows everything. This particular point, we see this sometimes, or this particular point, as relates to knowledge and Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala being aware. This was something that that group that we were referring to earlier, the Qadariya, likewise had a problem with. They likewise had a problem with this. And they denied that Allah had knowledge of the actions of the servant before they would do their action. That once the action was committed, Allah has awareness of it because He sees them, He hears them. But before the action was committed, Allah was unaware of what the person chooses to do. Now let me give an example of how twisted this understanding is. We have people in this dunya, especially some of our older brothers, whom Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala has bestowed upon them wisdom. And they may know somebody for years. And they literally can predict the movements of a person if they were placed in a certain circumstance. So much so, you'll find them saying, oh, if this happens to brother so-and-so, or if this happens to sister so-and-so, he's going to do this or she's going to do this. And then when you look into that affair, you find that what that person said was true. Is he all-knowing? No. But because of his awareness of that person and how they react in circumstances and situations, he's able to predict how they're going to, their movements in certain circumstances. Now this is as it relates to a person, man, creation. Now Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala
manageable as it relates to the innermost core affair of a thing. The innermost of a thing Allah has knowledge of. The most minute of a thing Allah has knowledge of. So if this human being is able to predict the movements of another based off his knowledge of the person, based off what he sees from the outside of the person, how is it that one would believe that Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala does not know what man is going to do when he is well acquainted with his creation? Has the utmost knowledge of the innermost being of that thing. How is it that one can say that Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala is ignorant as it relates to what man is going to do? This shows that the Qadariya had bad thoughts as it relates to Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala. They didn't understand the Lord whom which they were worshipping. Obviously. They didn't understand. So from belief in the decree of Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala, is to believe that Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala is the all-knower of everything. That his knowledge encompasses everything. There is nothing that is hidden from him. There is nothing that he is unaware of. On the contrary, he's aware of everything, and he's aware of everything in the most detailed of matters unimaginable to us. Because we cannot reach that level of knowledge that Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala has with him. The third thing that must be in place in order to actualize belief in the decree of Allah is al-kitabah, writing. And that is to believe that Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala wrote down everything that would take place in his creation until the day that the hour is established. Everything is written. And this shows us the tremendousness of our Lord. Everything is written. From what leaves fall from the tree and when they'll fall. When they'll change colors from green to brown. The varying tones of the colors. What wind will come and blow them away, and in which direction? This shows us, if we really contemplate on what's being said here, everything is written. This shows us that we're worshiping a Lord that is not like anything else. And so this particular point is found throughout the text of the Quran and the Sunnah as well. We have the hadith of Abdullah ibn Umar ibn al-As, which is collected by Imam Muslim, his Sahih. Where the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam stated, كَتَبَ اللَّهُ مَقَادِرَ الْخَلَائِقِ مِنْ قَبْلِ أَنْ يَخْلُقَ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضَ بِخَمْسِينَ أَلْفَ سَنَةٍ وَكَانَ أَرْشُهُ عَلَى الْمَاءِ. He stated that Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala, he wrote the measurements or the determination or the decree of the creation 50,000 years above the water. And his throne was above the water. In the narration of Ubadah ibn Samit, which is collected by Abu Dawud in his Sunan, and likewise by At-Tirmidhi fi Jami'ihi, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he stated, إِنَّ أَوَّلَ مَا خَلَقَ اللَّهُ الْقَلَمُ فَقَالَ اُكْتُبْ قَالَ رَبِّي وَمَاذَا أَكْتُبْ. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he stated, undoubtedly, the first thing that Allah created was the pen. And he said to the pen, write. And so the pen responded, oh, my Lord, what should I write? The Prophet ﷺ continued, he stated that Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala said, Uktub, maqadira kulli shay'in hatta taqum as-sa'a. Write the fate or the decree of everything.
everything. Of everything in this creation until the hour is established. Think about that, Ya'ibadullah. Everything from the creatures on this earth that we are unaware of to that which we are aware of, from all the multitudes of fish in the sea, all of it is written. When the fish will be, when the fish will come into existence, or a hatch from an egg. Do they hatch from eggs?
Yeah.
Hatch from an egg and when they die. And thus forth and so on. Which fish will be caught and be on your skillet? And thus forth and so on. All of these things are written. Things that would be considered insignificant, minute, who cares? All of these things are written. All of these things are written. So Allah Ta'ala is aware of what is in the creation and what will be in the creation. Allah Ta'ala says, أَلَمْ تَعْلَمْ أَنَّ اللَّهَ يَعْلَمُ مَا فِي السَّمَاءِ وَالْأَرْضِ إِنَّ ذَلِكَ فِي كِتَابٍ إِنَّ ذَلِكَ عَلَى اللَّهِ يَسِيرٌ. Do you not know that Allah is aware of whatsoever is in the sky and the earth? Indeed, that is in a book. And indeed, that is easy for Allah. Indeed, that is easy for Allah. As it is written. Likewise, things that will occur in this dunya, regardless if they're considered good or bad, Allah is aware of it. It is written. مَا أَصَابَ مِنْ مُصِيبَةٍ فِي الْأَرْضِ وَلَا فِي أَنْفُسِكُمْ إِلَّا فِي كِتَابٍ مِنْ قَبْلِ أَنْ نَبْرَأَهَا. There is no calamity that befalls or occurs in the earth or with yourselves except that it is in a book, yani written in a book before it comes into existence, before it is created. Before it is created. And this book, as we all know, is Al-Lawh Al-Mahfuz, the preserved tablet. Thus, no one actualizes belief in the Qadr of Allah until they believe in Al-Lawh Al-Mahfuz, this preserved tablet, and that everything that will occur in creation was written in it until the hour was established 50,000 years before Allah created the heavens and the earth. As Sheikh Muhammad ibn Salih al-Uthaymeen, he states, وَاللَّوْحَ الْمَحْفُوظُ لَا نَعْرَفُ مَاهِيَتَهُ مِنْ أَيِّ شَيْءٍ أَمِنْ الْخَشَبِ أَمِنْ حَدِيدٍ وَلَا نَعْرَفُ حَجْمَ هَذَا اللَّوْحِ وَلَا سَعَتَهُ فَاللَّهُ أَعْلَمُ بِذَلِكَ. He says, this preserved tablet, we are unaware of which material it is made from.
So,
is it from wood or is it from iron? We are unaware of this. We have no knowledge of this. We are unaware of its size. As the Shaykh continues, we are unaware of its size and its width. But, however, Allah is most knowledgeable concerning this. He is most knowledgeable concerning this. And then Shaykh Al-Uthaymeen, he says something important. And وَالْوَاجِبْ أَنْ نُؤْمِنَ بِأَنَّ هُنَاكَ لَوْحًا كَتَبَ اللَّهُ فِيهِ مَقَادِرَ كُلِّ شَيْءٍ. That it is obligatory upon the Muslim to believe that there is a preserved tablet in which Allah Ta'ala has wrote the fate or the decree of everything therein. It is obligatory for us to believe this. And it is not correct for any of us to try to do research and search for answers beyond that. To search for answers beyond that.
So that is the third thing that must be in place in order for a person to have belief in Al-Qadr. The fourth and the last thing is to have belief in Al-Mashi'a, or Mashi'atullah, the will of Allah. And that is everything that occurs in this creation is by Allah's will. Whatever Allah wills is, and whatever He does not will is not. It does not come into existence. If He doesn't will it, it doesn't come into existence. As Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala, He says in His noble book, يَا أَيُّهَا الْإِنسَانُ مَا غَرَّكَ بِرَبِّكَ الْكَرِيمِ الَّذِي خَلَقَكَ فَسَوَّاكَ فَعَدَلَكَ فِي أَيِّ سُورَةٍ مَا شَاءَ رَكَّبَكَ. Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala He says, I think I'm going to just read the translation. Alright. Oh man, what has made you careless about your Lord, the most generous, who created you, fashioned you perfectly, and gave you due proportion? And in whatever form He willed, He put you together. In whatever form He willed, He put you together. Sheikh Muhammad ibn Salih al-Uthaymeen, in his explanation to Al-Aqidah al-Wasatiyah, he has some beautiful speech as it relates to what is intended by the Mashi'ah of Allah, or the will of Allah. He states, وَمَشِيَّةُ اللَّهِ هِيَ إِرَادَتُهُ الْكَوْنِيَّةِ. He says, the will of Allah, it is His universal objectives, or universal objective. وَهِيَ نَافِذَةٌ فِيمَا يُحِبُّهُ وَمَا لَا يُحِبُّهُ وَنَافِذَةٌ عَلَى جَمِيعِ الْعِبَادِ بِدُونْ تَفْصِيلٍ. And it is, its execution pertains to what He loves and what He does not love. And He enforces it upon all of His servants without any exception. He enforces His will or His want upon all of His servants without objection. وَلَا بُدَّ مِنْ وُجُودْ مَا شَاءَهُ بِكُلِّ حَالٍ. And it is incumbent the coming into existence or the existence of whatsoever He wills, regardless of what the circumstance may be. That is from every upon every condition. فَكُلُّ مَا شَاءَ اللَّهُ وَقَعَ وَلَا بُدْ. All of that which Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala wills occurs. It occurs. سَوَاءٌ كَانَ فِيمَا يُحِبُّهُ وَيَرْضَاهُ أَمْ لَا. Regardless of his, is that which He loves and is pleased with or not? And again, whatever Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala wills is from the perspective of wisdom. From the perspective of wisdom. So it is not to be understood from these statements of Sheikh Muhammad ibn Salih al-Uthaymeen, it is not to be understood as some of the misguided groups of the past understood it, like the Jabariya. They understood the will of Allah to be that mankind was forced to do what we do when we had no choice or will of our own. That we had no choice in the matter and will of our own. Why? Because whatever Allah wills, He does. And whatever Allah wills, it is. And whatever He does not will, it is not. So they had a crooked or incorrect understanding that we are forced to do what we do. Then we have the Qadariya that stated that the will of man was outside of the will of Allah. And so whatever we will to do, It had no, that Allah's will had no bearing on it whatsoever. These are two groups that had a misunderstanding as it relates to the Lord of all that exists. And had a misunderstanding as it relates to the text of the Quran and the Sunnah. As Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala, He states, لِمَنْ شَاءَ مِنْكُمْ أَنْ يَسْتَقِيمُ وَمَا يَتَشَاءُنَّ إِلَّا أَنْ يَشَاءَ اللَّهُ رَبُّ الْعَالَمِينَ Whomever from amongst you all wills to be upright. This particular verse is disproving the claim of the Jabariyyah. As it shows that man has a choice, that man wills to do what he does. Whoever from amongst you wills to be upright, then you do not will except that Allah, Lord, or all that exists wills it to be. Whatever you will to do, it cannot come to fruition. Unless Allah wills it to come to fruition. Whatever you set out to do, whatever you hope to accomplish, this is by your will and your choice. But if Allah wants you to accomplish that thing, to achieve whatever it is you're trying to achieve, then by His will, you'll achieve it. But if He does not want you to, will for you to achieve this thing, then it doesn't matter how much effort you put forth, it will never come to fruition. They never come to fruition. So both of this particular, the second part of this verse, وَمَا تَشَاءُونَ إِلَّا أَنْ يَشَاءَ اللَّهُ رَبُّ الْعَالَمِينَ is a response or disapproves of the idea or the understanding of the Qadariyya who said that man's will was outside of the will of Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala. Was outside of the will of Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala. As the actions of man, that which man wills, that which man wants and desires, that which man puts forth, they are directly connected to man, without a doubt, because he's the one that chooses to do them. He's the one that puts forth efforts to enact these, whatever it is he's trying to enact. Right? But likewise, they are connected to Allah. Not in a direct sense, but indirect, not in a direct sense like they are to men, but they are in an indirect sense because whatever a person attempts to do, Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala is the one that decreed it. And that willed for him to do it and to accomplish that thing. So the action of man, again, the action of man is linked to him directly because he's the one that put forth the action, puts forth the action and chose to do it. But it's also linked to Allah indirectly because Allah decreed for it to take place and He willed for it to take place. These four things must be in place in order for one to have belief in the decree of Allah. And we only found these groups, the Qadariyya and the Jabariyya, deviating in this regard due to their evil thoughts or incorrect understanding as it relates to the one to whom we direct our acts of worship. This is how this deviation came about. And for this reason, they are considered to be from the 72 astray or destroyed groups and which the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam referred to when he said, all of them are in the fire except one. Due to them holding incorrect understandings or incorrect beliefs about the Lord of all that exists and spreading them and propagating them. Of course, this is just a starting point to belief in the decree. And as usual, it will be incumbent for the believers to go to the classes of Aqidah to get a more detailed understanding. But the reality is, this is a summarized version of what should be in place. And with that, subhanaka allahumma wa bihamdik, ashhadu an la ilaha illa anta astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayk.